Hi, AppSec engineers. In this video, we'll be looking at the four in-demand security engineering skills for 2023 and beyond. Stay tuned to the end of the video because I'm going to give you a bonus skill set that is going to be really important for you 2023 and beyond. Let's get started. Before we get started with the video, I highly encourage you to subscribe to this channel and to like this video. It will help us reach more of you who want to get an amazing career in application security or security engineering. This will really help out all of those people who are interested in this sort of content. Unless you've been hiding under a rock, you probably know that security engineering is one of the hottest new career paths that you have, especially after the COVID pandemic. So if you have anything to do with security engineering, application security, cloud security, Kubernetes security architecture, you are going to have a bright career. However, you will have a bright career only if you have certain skill set. Certain skill set makes your career from an ordinary career to an amazing career to an extraordinary capability. So this video, we're going to be talking about some of these things, specifically four things that can catapult your career from a good or an ordinary career to an extraordinary career in terms of security engineering skills. Unlike theoretical knowledge, knowing these things in a way that you can actually implement them will make you a really strong security, especially application security professional. So with that in mind, let's get started with the four skills that will make you a much better security engineer 2023 and beyond. And remember, these are the ones that are highly in demand for companies, and these are the things that companies are really looking to scale up and implement in the year 2023 and beyond. Let's start off with the first skill that I think is going to be really, really important in 2023 and beyond. And this one relates to application security, and this one specifically relates to static analysis. I know you thought static analysis was boring. You thought static analysis was dead. Turns out it's not. Now, static analysis has made a huge comeback, especially in the world of application security, because turns out that people still like to find issues with their source code as quickly as possible in the life cycle to be able to ensure that they don't ship out vulnerable code. So static analysis has made a big return to grace in terms of application security. And you're seeing an amazing resurgence of a lot of amazing tools in static analysis, from SendGrep to CodeQL to a lot of infrastructure as code scanners and so on. Static analysis is becoming a very important skill to have, specifically the ability to not only set up and configure static analysis, but to also be able to customize static analysis. And with static analysis, I'm specifically referring to SendGrep. Now, SendGrep is probably one of my most favorite tools for static analysis, simply because SendGrep allows you to compose static analysis rules very easily. It kind of has this mixture of using regular expressions as well, but it actually allows you to do much more optimized code searching. It allows you to do source and sync and taint analysis and so on. So SendGrep has become one of the most important tools in the static analysis space. And it has also been utilized by organizations far and wide, large and small, and even open source projects. So you'll see a lot of rule sets out there on GitHub and so on SendGrep, which makes it a really, really powerful project. And since it has been driven through the open source community, its adoption, I think, within organizations as well has gone up quite a bit. Every conference I go to, everyone I meet is talking about SendGrep and being able to spin up new SendGrep rules or customize SendGrep rules and so on and so forth. So knowing SendGrep is going to be a very, very important thing for 2023 and beyond. In fact, one of the reasons why we've added SendGrep in our static analysis course in our DevSecOps learning path and AppSecEngineer is simply because this very reason. We caught on to the SendGrep fever pretty much, I think, earlier than most people, and we really are in love with the tool. We use it pretty much every day for a lot of our stuff, and we really believe that SendGrep is going to be the next big thing. And this is the skill that you need to have, simply because organizations want to do more static analysis, which means that they want to be able to customize roles. If they want to be able to customize roles, they need to know how this tool works and know how the customization works. So using SendGrep, learning SendGrep, especially understanding the syntax and composing rules and so on, is going to be very, very useful for you as a security engineer, especially in application security in 2023. So I would highly recommend learning SendGrep and figuring out how it works in detail. Let's talk about the next skill that I think that you need to have when it comes to having an amazing security engineering career, especially for 2023 and beyond, and that is open policy agent. And now you'll be wondering, why on earth are you talking about a tool and especially a policy tool? What is the big deal? And what on earth is Open Policy Agent? Now, one of the things that you would have seen, especially in the last 2-3 years that have happened, is APIs have just grown like crazy. Distributed computing has grown like crazy. We're deploying more containers than ever. You have Kubernetes clusters running all over the place. You have cloud being utilized, multi-cloud environments, and so on. You've seen a large proliferation of distributed computing. Now, the first thing that you will think about is, how on earth do I secure all of this? How do I bring some method to my madness? And that's where policy comes into the picture. Now, Open Policy Agent is basically not a tool so much as it is a language. It's basically a framework. It has a language, it has an evaluation engine. It's a full technology stack in itself for managing policy. So it allows you to write policies. It could be anything from an access control policy to an input validation policy to an API gateway policy. Whatever it is that you need, you can write it out as a policy, and Open Policy Agent will start enforcing the policy based on the rules that you have written. Now, this has become a very, very important aspect, especially when it comes to API security and Kubernetes security and container security. And in fact, Open Policy Agent, it's made its way even into the operating system as well. So you can apply policies anywhere, and Open Policy Agent is a system that allows you to do that. Now, Open Policy Agent is really powerful because it uses its own domain-specific language called Rego. And Rego allows you to compose all of these different policy parameters, and you can start enforcing them and evaluating them based on requests coming in from the user or somebody trying to launch a container on your Kubernetes cluster or so on and so forth. So Open Policy Agent is something that companies are really looking to, because they want to have a method to the madness. If you don't have a method to the madness, you don't have policy management and policy enforcement, you are really going to quickly lose control over the massive distributed ecosystem that you have created for yourself. So Open Policy Agent is going to become increasingly more and more important as you start to progress in security engineering, and knowing it hands-on is going to be very, very important. In fact, right now I'm authoring a course on Open Policy Agent, which is going to be a very, very important addition to our AppSec Engineer library. And I think it's going to be a very important thing for people to learn in 2023 and beyond. Let's look at skill number 3 on our 4 important security engineering skills for 2023 and beyond. And this skill specifically refers to infrastructure as code, and even more specifically is around Terraform. Now, one of the things you would have probably noticed is that cloud security is the future, right? Everyone is going to be on the cloud, or at least a lot of us are going to be on the cloud. A lot of our companies are going to be on the cloud. They're already on the cloud, or they're migrating to the cloud, or they're doing transformation projects that leads them to being on the cloud. So cloud is an inevitability for most of us. And when you are moving to the cloud, one of the things that is also an inevitability is cloud security. So what you want to do is you want to learn cloud and cloud security. But how do you do this? In the sense that, do you log into the AWS console and start to deploy resources, or do you log into Azure or Google Cloud and start to deploy resources, you know, point and click? No, that never happens within companies. If you really look at how companies deploy resources on the cloud, they use infrastructure as code, and a lot of them use one tool for infrastructure as code, which is Terraform. Now, Terraform is a infrastructure as code tool from HashiCorp. And one of the things that Terraform allows you to do is it has a whole bunch of APIs and providers and things like that, that allow you to create and deploy and manage your resources and state on the cloud through infrastructure as code. Now, Terraform uses a specialized domain specific language called the HashiCorp configuration language, which is a special purpose language just for infrastructure as code. And they use it for nearly all of their products, from Vault to Waypoint to any of their products that they have. HashiCorp uses this, and Terraform also inherently uses this. Now, Terraform, of course, has become so big that even you have Terraform providers for Python and so on. And it's something that has become extremely influential in the world of infrastructure as code. So learning Terraform not only cements your quality and qualifications in terms of cloud skills, but also cements your capability in terms of cloud security skills. Remember, because a lot of these infrastructure as code scripts make their way, and of course they're deployed on the cloud. They're the ones that are actually deploying and managing things on the cloud. So a lot of the security flaws, just like static analysis, stem from these infrastructure as code scripts that may be vulnerable or that may have insecure configurations and so on. So knowing infrastructure as code is going to make a huge difference in stepping up your security engineering skills game. In fact, on AppSecEngineer, all of our cloud labs on AWS and Azure, and even our challenges that we've started off recently, all have Terraform. That's how much we believe in Terraform. And that's how much we believe that Terraform is going to be something that you are going to need as a security engineer 2023 and beyond. Now it brings us to the final and the fourth skill set, which I said was a bonus. And this is something that is last, but certainly not least. We started off this video with AppSec and we're going to end it with AppSec. And one of the things that I think you should know as a security engineer, especially in 2023 in AppSec, is DAST. Now you'll be thinking, oh my God, what do you mean DAST? I use Burp Suite. I use Zap. I'm cool like that. What do you mean DAST? By DAST, I specifically mean a tool called Nuclei. Now Nuclei, if you are a bug bounty hunter, you'll probably know Nuclei like the back of your hand, but Nuclei has become one of the most influential tools in the space of application security, especially to find bugs, to be able to find bugs at massive scale, at massive speed. But beyond just the bug finding thing, Nuclei has become a very important tool to integrate into your DevSecOps pipeline because it's able to do things that a lot of the previous scanners that came before it, especially Burp or Zap or so on, are not able to do. It's able to triangulate and scan specific flaws that you can customize. Again, the customization angle comes into Nuclei quite a bit. Now, just like SemGrep, Nuclei can be composed. Nuclei templates and rules can be written in YAML, which makes it very accessible. Unlike, imagine changing a Burp rule or imagine changing a Zap rule or Zap script or something like that. It's doable. And if you are aware of that stuff, if you're able to debug, I mean, it is something that you can do, but Nuclei has taken customization to the next level because you can write your own YAML scripts. You can make it so much easier for you to write and of course to roll out as part of a DevSecOps pipeline that becomes a very important tool to add to your arsenal. Your organization is going to want to be able to test their applications and APIs en masse and at scale. And Nuclei is something that they are going to look to for doing this. And this is something that you should look to from a career standpoint as well, which is why recently we added a new course on Nuclei and AppSec Engineer, simply because we believe in this so much. We believe that Nuclei gives you the ability to scale up exponentially in your DevSecOps journey and makes it very, very important tool, especially as a security engineer in 2023 and beyond. So with that, we have our four skills that you will need for being a great security engineer 2023 and beyond. Of course, you need to have not just theoretical knowledge in these things, but also expand your vistas by having hands-on knowledge. That's why we focus so much on the hands-on part in AppSec Engineer, simply because just having theory knowledge is not going to make any sense. So definitely keep these four in mind. Think about how you want to learn them. Of course, if you want, you always have AppSec Engineer to get you the most distilled and crystallized knowledge that you need in all of these things and more. I look forward to seeing you in other videos of ours. Thank you so much and have a great rest of your day.